Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video, we'll be learning about the looping statement in Python. Okay, so what is a looping statement in Python and what does the term looping mean? So let us first understand the meaning of the term looping. Looping means when you want to execute the same statements again and again, so that is considered as a loop. For example, if you want to print, let's say number 1 10 times like this, okay, or maybe 5 times, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So if you want to print, see, the same statement is being repeated 5 times. That means we want to print the number 5, number 1, 5 times. So this statement can be put in a loop. Instead of using 5 print statements for printing this, that means instead of writing like this, print 1, 5 times, what we could do is, we could put, instead of putting 5 such statements, let's see, Control C and Control V, 3, 4, 5. Okay, so instead of writing print statements 5 times to print this number 1, since the statement is being repeated, we could have put the statement in a loop. So what is this looping statement? In Python, the looping statement is called while. Okay, this is a looping statement. So let's first see the syntax of the looping statement. And while it may seem easier to, you know, to have 5 print statements, but imagine what if we had to do, let's suppose we had to print this number 1 20 times or 100 times. So would we be writing this print statement 100 times? No, that would not be feasible. So that is why we have this loop statement. So let's understand the syntax of the loop statement. And in this program, what we will be doing is, let's suppose we want to print the number 1 5 times, okay? So let us take a variable A, and we say A is, we initialize A to be 1, and here we take another variable B, B is equal to 1. So we have taken two variables A and B, both are initialized to 1, and now we will write while. After while, we will write the condition. Now the condition, as I said, we want to print number 1, we want to print 1 5 times. So the loop has to be executed how many times? 5 times. So let's say while B is less than equal to 5, and again put a colon here, press enter, the indentation will automatically take place, and here we will write print, and we can print A. And don't put single quotes or double quotes around A, because that would actually print A, whereas we want the value of A to be printed. So in that case, we should print simply A without the quotes. After that, here in the next line, we will write B is equal to B plus 1, or we can use the shorthand assignment B plus equal to 1. If you do not understand this, you can watch my previous video on operators. And that is it. This is a while block continuing, and when you press enter and you do not write anything after that, the while block will finish. Okay, now we save this program, and here let's run it now. Run, and we can click this run module, and you see number 1 was printed 5 times. So this program was pretty easy to understand. If you see here, after writing while, you have to put the condition and then you have to put the semicolon. Now why is the condition 5? Because we wanted the number to be printed 5 times. Okay, now let's take another program in which we would print the first 10 natural numbers. That means the output of this program should be, let's say it should print like this, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and till 10, first 10 natural numbers. Okay, so let's start. Let's change this program. Here in this program again, to just to print first in natural numbers, we take A to be 1, and here we do not need a second variable in this case, and we can do with one variable only. So we'll say while A is less than equal to how many numbers we want to be printed? 10. So we will write while A is less than equal to 10, again put a colon, then we print A here, and after that we write A plus equal to 1. Okay, now in Python we do not have those increment and decrement operators, A++ and A minus minus. So that is why we use this shorthand. So those operators are available in other languages like C and Java, but not in Python. Okay, so if you already are wondering why we are not using, if you are an experienced programmer, you must be wondering why aren't we using A++, because A++ is not available in Python. Okay, so we write like this and that's it. And we just save this program and you run it. And let's see, so here it goes 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So it prints first 10 natural numbers. So all we have done here is we took A to be 1 initially, that if the condition is true, this condition will be evaluated initially. If the condition is true, then it enters the while block and it prints the first value of a, which is 1. Then in the next statement, the value of a becomes a plus equal to 1 means a, the previous value of a, and 1 is added to that. So a becomes 2. Again, it will go here. The condition is true. 2 is less than 10, so it prints 2. Now a becomes 2 plus 1, 3. So again, it will go here. 3 is less than 10. So as long as this condition is true, these two statements will be executed again and again. So this is what we mean by looping statements. Okay. So let's suppose initial value of I was 11. A was 11. So in this case, if you see, what will be the output of this program if A is initially 11? So if initially A is 11, the condition is false initially only. So in this case, it will not enter the loop because the condition is false and nothing will be, there will be no output. So let's run it and see. And when you run it, see there's no output. That is because the condition is false initially. So when the condition is false initially, the loop is not executed. Let me print another statement here which is outside the loop. So if it is outside the loop, remember indentation is important, and let's print done. Okay, so let's print done. And you can use single or double quotes, save it, and let's see now A is 11. So all we should see on the screen is done, because it doesn't enter the loop, it just prints the statement which is outside the loop. So let's run it, and here you see done. But if I change the value of, okay, which let me just close this output window and the shell. Okay, now if I change the value of A to 1, and again I run this, now the condition is true, 1 is less than 10. So first the state loop will be executed 10 times and then it will print done. So that means output would be 1, it will print the first 10 natural numbers and then it will print done. So let's see. So you see this output, okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and then till 10, and then it prints done. So this is how the looping statement or the statements are executed within a loop. Okay, so whenever we want to repeat some statements, we will put them in a while loop. Okay, so I hope you like this video, and please don't forget to click on the like button and subscribe to the channel estudy.in, and thanks for watching.